2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
And Professor Clare Collins, this time around you have brought us some fantastic good news. Now, most of us love a bowl of pasta. However, we sometimes think, oh, is it good for us? Is it bad for us? Luckily, now it turns out that we can actually eat pasta. It's okay. Good morning.
Yes, good morning. There's been a major systematic review has come out that's actually shown it's okay to eat pasta, but there are a few caveats.
Oh, there's always a sting in the tail, isn't there? So why has it now, what's the research telling us that, hey, pasta's okay?
Okay, so what these researchers did, it's called a systematic review. So they looked at all of the studies being done that included getting people to eat pasta. And there were 29 studies, and these were randomized control trials. So what that means is they said to one group, go for your lives. Not, they didn't quite, but you get the idea.
How do I get into those groups?
Yeah, and the other group was, you just keep doing the same. But both of them were groups of studies where you're either told to continue on with your usual eating habits or to lose weight, basically. But what the caveat is that, yes, they were allowed to eat pasta, but it was as part of what's called a low glycemic index diet.
Okay, so for those who may not be completely aware, what does make up a low glycemic index diet?
Okay, so a low glycemic index means you're having the types of carbohydrate foods that are slower to digest. And when you delve down into the structure of these carbohydrates, it means if you put them under a microscope, the carbohydrate molecules look a bit more like the branches of a tree rather than the beads on a necklace. So that when enzymes have to digest up those carbohydrates, they go, oh, will I go on that branch or will I just... And if it's a branch-structured carbohydrate, that's slow to do that. Whereas if the carbohydrates are lined up neatly like beads in a necklace, you just go chop, 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 chop.
That would be your can of soft drink, probably.
Probably. or even something like glucose, which, you know, you can buy that up in a bottle. So low glycemic index, other examples, mixed grain breads, muesli, what else? Things like cracker biscuits that are multigrain. Fruits like grapefruit, apricot, oranges, and then sweet potato, yogurt, milk, things like that.
So when it comes to pasta, was this research like all types of pasta or were there some pastas that were better than others?
Interesting, they didn't actually declare that, but it wasn't particularly wholemeal pasta. So when you jump into the studies, what can we find about how much pasta they ate? On average, they had about 3.5 serves a week. Now, that is not a lot of pasta. It's about 1.7 cups. And the low glycemic index pasta eating groups, they lost about 600 grams more over 3 months compared to the other group who were not told to go on a low glycemic index diet.
Okay. And even though 600 grams doesn't seem like a lot, you're still trending downward. You're still going in the right direction.
And it's more weight loss than the group who didn't have that extra caveat of low glycemic index. The other good news, when they looked at just the studies that included people with type 2 diabetes or just the studies where people were more overweight or just older people, the results were the same. So the good news is, yes, you can have pasta, but watch the serve size. Did you know that a serve size is actually only considered to be half a cup?
I think we need to actually redefine the term serving. Or what is a proper serving size? Not cutting it.
Yeah, and I think the message is, so for many people, the serving size is too big. And I think another key message to remember is that garlic bread and cheese are actually not vegetables.
See, you give with one hand and you taketh with the other, for sure.
So when you're dishing up your plate, here's a rule of thumb. Divide it in two, one quarter the pasta, one quarter the meat sauce, and one half make that the salad, and then you can enjoy pasta way more regularly.
And get rid of that 600 grams extra.
Yeah, even if you're trying to lose weight or you're trying to manage your diabetes.
Now, migraines, you've got those on your mind as well with a new study coming up?
That's right. We mentioned a couple of weeks ago we had a study coming up for people with severe headaches or migraines. Well, we're launching that today. So if you go to the 2NUR website, you'll be able to click on the link to check out whether or not you're eligible. And what we're doing in that study is we're going to try out two different dietary approaches to see if we can help people with migraine. And the good news on this study is you get to trial both, but just some people will try one diet first and some people will try the other. But you'll get to experience both to see if we can help you bust those frequent headaches.
All that information is actually giving me a headache, Claire. So we might leave it there this time. Thank you for all of that and exciting news about pasta. Well done.
Yes. Enjoy.
That's Claire Collins joining us on 2NURFM 103.7.